Hello, my dear students. In the last class, we were discussing on different components on electric drives. And in this class, we are going to describe the control unit. Actually, you can say that any control unit, it is the brain of the electric drive. It is the brain of the electric drive. So the control unit controls the power modulator, which operates at small voltage and power levels. The control unit also operates the power modulator as desired. So the control unit controls the power modulator, which operates at small voltage and power levels. So the voltage in this particular case is very small. That means you can say it is in the range of delta V, and if it is power, it is delta P. That means the control output, that means the controlled output at the voltage level, it is very small, and the control unit operates the power modulator as desired. So that is the main objective of a control unit. The control unit should be able to achieve the desired levels. What levels? That means the torque and speed. So as I was discussing in the last class, let us represent a simple control system. So let this be a drive, which is denoted by D. And here we have a controller, which is denoted by C, and here we are getting the output, which is RS. So your input is CS. So the feedback is given by FP. So this is your system, and you need to operate this system. And what will be your response? The response will be your torque and speed. And your input should be a particular voltage, right? Which will operate the controller, and the controller will drive the system. And there should be some reference signal. What will be the reference? The torque and the speed will be the reference. So the reference will be, if I write it more clearly, the reference signal will be tau REF and omega REF. REF stands for reference. And the job of the controller is to monitor the torque and speed continuously and compare them with the reference inputs. So it also generates the commands for the protection of the power modulator and the motor. An input command signal which adjusts the operating point of the drive from an input to the control unit. So it generates the command for the protection of the power modulator and the motor. So the job of the controller is to protect the power modulator and the motor. Why? Because you see, since it always compares with the reference signals and the output, so it will obviously keep the torque and speed of the machine or the motor within the limits. And the limits will not be violated. And when the torque speed limits is not violated, that means I can also assume, or rather I can infer rather, the current which is drawn by the motor should lie between the rated current, provided tau equal to, or rather less than equal to, tau rated and omega less than equal to omega rated. So if the speed and torque are within the limits, the power output, which is nothing but tau omega, will be less than equal to P rated. And if it is less than equal to P rated, then obviously I will be less than equal to I rated. So I hope now it is clear. So next comes the sensing unit. So it senses the certain drive parameter like motor current and speed. So again, let us draw the diagram. So here you have the error detector. Here you have the controller. I missed one thing in the last feedback block, or the block diagram rather. I have missed the power modulator. So after the power modulator, you have the drive D. And the drive will give you the torque and the speed. And this speed will be sensed by the sensor. And here it will again compare the values with the tau and omega reference, and it will just provide an input to the controller. So this tau is tau REF and this omega is equal to omega REF. So this is your block diagram. And I have already told you that it is mainly required either for protection or for closed loop operation. So definitely this is a closed loop, and it is used in case of a closed loop operation. So the sensor is basically a transducer. So in machine laboratory, or when we perform any experiments on electrical machines, how do we detect the speed? How do we detect the speed? We detect the speed by means of a tachometer. So what is a tachometer? So it is something like this. When it is coupled with the motor shaft, what will happen? There is a display which is rated at RPM. So when this rotating part rotates, suppose the machine output is tau and it is omega. So generally it will sense omega. So the omega which is given over here, correspondingly it will generate some voltage which will convert the voltage to RPM. So basically speed is converted to voltage and the voltage is converted to RPM. again inside this tachometer, what is happening? The rotational energy is converted into electrical energy, and that electrical energy is giving some output voltage, which output voltage corresponds to some RPM. And you remember, this voltage is very, very small. This is very, very small. It is a small scale voltage, maybe in the order of millivolts. So basically, this sensing unit in one way acts as a protective mechanism or for closed loop operation. So definitely it is a closed loop operation. Now next comes the advantage of electric drives. So obviously electric drives have some advantages. So the first advantage is a wide range of torque, speed and power. And definitely you require a wide range of torque, speed and power. Why? Because you see, there are different applications or different types of industries rather. It may be a cement mill, it may be a rolling mill, it may be a flour mill. So different types of mills are there, and the speed torque requirement of the motors which are used in those respective mills are having diverse torque speed requirement or power requirement, and that's why it is very essential for the electric drives to be available for a wide range. That means the torque, the omega and the power, they should be for a wide range of operation. And what type of motor I should use, what type of electric drive I should employ, it depends on my application. It depends that what type of application it is subjected to. So some motors may be required for heavy duty load. Some type of motors are there, they may be used for intermittent duty load or medium loads. And some motors may be requiring which are used for light duty loads. So obviously the speed torque requirements are different, the loading capabilities are also different. They are adaptable to almost any operating conditions. So this is very important. It can be subjected to any sort of operating conditions, such as even explosive condition, radioactive environment may be there. It may be submerged in liquids. It may have a vertical mounting. So you see that all these environments, they are different, they are not same. And an electric drive is subjected to any of these adverse environments or different environments. So it should be able to bear any adverse situations or very adverse situation, not any, but very adverse situation. And here lies the advantage of an electric drive. Electric motors, they are adaptable in almost any operating condition. And the last but not the least, which is very required for nowadays, it is very, very environmental friendly. It does not pollute the environment. Because you see, when you are operating an electric drive, what is happening? It is not causing any pollution. It is not causing any pollution rather. So it is very, very environmental friendly. because nowadays we are going for sustainable development. I can say that the development is sustainable only if it doesn't jeopardize the environment or deplete the natural resources. Only then you can say that it is environment friendly. Now next comes the advantages of electric drives. Now the main advantage is that it can operate in all the four quadrants of speed torque plane. So let me explain this particular thing. So suppose you are having a motor and here is the shaft. So what may be the different combinations? You are applying some voltage. You may change the polarity of the voltage. So what may be the different possible directions of torque and speed? In one case, the torque may be clockwise. In the second case, the torque may be anti-clockwise, the speed may be clockwise, the speed may be anti-clockwise. So these are the different possible combinations. So based on the directions of the torque and speed, what I can do is I can divide the operational quadrants into four regions. The torque is represented by x-axis. The speed is represented by y-axis. So in all these four quadrants, in the first quadrant, the torque is positive and the omega is positive, both are positive. In the second quadrant, the torque is negative, the speed is positive. In the third quadrant, both the torque and speeds, they are negative. And what about the fourth quadrant? In the fourth quadrant, the torque is positive and the speed is negative. So these are the four possible quadrants of operation based on the direction. So that means the direction of operation is very, very flexible. You can choose your direction. Let me give you an example. Suppose there is a mill, and suppose there is a motor in the mill which is required to operate in the clockwise direction for 5 seconds, and in the next 5 seconds it is required to produce a negative force, a negative torque. For the next again 10 seconds, it has to produce a positive torque. Then for the next 10 seconds, it is required to produce a negative torque. So that means the motor has to be driven in all the four quadrants. And for that, an electric drive is an ideal device to satisfy such need. So the operation of an electric drive is very, very, very flexible in this particular regard. The next advantage is that they can be started almost instantly, and they can be immediately be fully loaded. Why you see that? The starting time, if I denote the starting time as TST, that is very, very less. Very, very less. That means whenever it is desired to start, it can start at that particular instant only. And suppose you are starting at a particular instant, and immediately you can load the motor fully. You need not refuel or warm up the motor. Instant activities can be done, which is a very, very flexible operation in case of an electric drive. And the control, which I was saying, it is very flexible. They have flexible control characteristics, and it can be employed to automatically control the drive. As I told you, that there may be a mill where there is a motor and you have a positive torque requirement, a negative torque requirement, a positive speed requirement, or a negative speed requirement, any values, you can do it instantly without any hitch. These are some of the advantages of electric drives. And for the next advantages, we will be taking it up in the next class. Thank you.